West Coast, then still good morning. Still good morning. Still good morning. But for everybody else, good afternoon. Unless, of course, by some strange reason you're watching this from the other side of the pond, then good evening? Maybe? I don't know. Anyway, so we're back. And as you can tell by the top center, we're back in the Super B. Went through and picked up a couple things. Trying theories out. And whenever you do stuff like this, this is what you're going to end up doing, is you're going to do a whole bunch of trial and error and add stuff, take stuff away, so on and so forth. Now, the Super B is not available in the used car lot at the moment. I don't remember seeing it. They added a couple of them, but they were like four cylinders and stuff like that. So things that I've added. Okay, so you saw me buy the high-end supercharger. Well, I just picked up the low end to see if there's any difference, and then I also increased the body rigidity because yeah, why not? Trial and error. And just because the high-end supercharger or may react a certain way, maybe the low end will react a different way at a different time. Maybe, possible. Anywho, alrighty. Enough chit chat, let's get to Le Mans. Alrighty. So I'm currently at 682. We're gonna kind of do a little bit more tinkering here a little bit before we get back on the track. Because again, I've got the Challenger that I've got dialed in. I really and truly do. Every time I run it, it runs flawlessly. Well, not flawlessly. I mean, you still have to kind of manipulate the throttle in certain aspects, and you really can't run it wide open unless you're on a straight stretch. The one nice part about Le Mans is it gives you those straight stretches. Now, there are certain tracks that give you a mix of sharp corners, sweeping corners, so on and so forth, which would probably be a little bit more appropriate to do this type of stuff, but unfortunately, I'm not doing it. I don't know why. Okay, let's go into settings. Detailed settings. So, let's have one of those for rear. Body height adjustment. I'm almost got this thing bottomed out. I really don't want to bottom it out because I still need the suspension to do stuff. Bump both of these up by a quarter and see if that makes any kind of difference. Alrighty. There's that. Okay, so things that I've kind of farted around with and took it in a backwards direction, apparently. But again, just because the numbers on the upper left underneath the car say they're going down, that's not necessarily a bad thing, because sometimes you need to go through and adjust things. Probably not going to be doing a full race yet. We're just going to go through and just kind of see how a half a lap feels or a lap feels. That is so not what I wanted. That's what I want. Oh, bugger. More with the low end. Definitely tracking better. So in this big mammoth jammer, we're going to start braking to try out... Oh, no, wrong board. I do that too, especially on this long straight stretch. Back out of there. Sorry, I gotta send a text out real quick. There we go. Ta-da! Alrighty, so. Alright, let's go to settings. Settings. Okay, so I mean, the suspension seems to be doing exactly what I want it to do. Okay, so actually, you know what? Let's try something, because I mean, I should have done this prior to tracking it the first time. Why don't we see what this 383 will do? Because I didn't do that. I just threw a supercharger on it and said, to hell with it. Still got good pep. But it can will still ass end will still kick out even with just the motor. Alrighty, so let's see if we can get the braking marker correct on this one. $200 Actually, I might be able to wait for the marshals. Dude, I weigh more than you do. You guys saw it. The AI tried to bump me out of the way. Fruitcakes. Alrighty, so I don't have that, like, explosive I may not have the explosive, like, off-the-line power, but, I mean, it's still doing okay. Still tracking good. Still throwing down enough torque to the rear wheel to where it will kick the ass end out. So yeah. I'm almost wondering or starting to think if maybe, because I mean everything is tall on this car and I've got it kind of really tall gears in it because of, well, I mean, the top speed that I need, and I can only do it with a 5-speed manual, because again, in these cars, I mean, the racing transmission is 5-speed. So, it's not like the Charger SRT Hellcat, it's got like an 8-speed transmission. So, but that car gets up to 200 quite well, all on its own. Oh, so you don't have a, sorry, yeah, that was a wee bit unprofessional. So, yeah, obviously, just like in real life, properties in motion tend to stay in motion. This is a big old car, with a big old engine, so it's going to take a little bit more time to stop it. But I mean, the car is tracking nicely. I mean, the other thing to keep in mind is you don't need to drop 20K or 23K or however much I spent on each supercharger. And you can get more horsepower out of your engine by just going through and boring it out and adding the polished kits. And I mean, you can do it with just the motor. This is just the motor. True, in other attempts, I have been higher than 14, but I mean the car is a wee bit more manageable. With that being said, I have no problems with having to fight with the car a little bit. So if you're just starting out, okay, my encouraging words of advice is to go through and just work on the motor, especially when you're dealing with something like a 383 or 429, 427. I wonder. Okay, so I've got both superchargers now. And I've got those off. So, I wonder, because I mean, the big block motors, they're not known for their off the line speed. They're known for their top end. Le Mans is one of those tracks that you can use just top end on. So just the engine alone. Now keep in mind, when we first started this little endeavor with a muscle car and trying to turn it into a road car, let me run back over to my garage real quick before we go back to the tuning shop. Come on, let me in. Again, please be patient. I am on a PS4. At this point in time, could dollars at work? And before you make the comments, yes, I did go down and buy the calipers that are color matched to my car. Why? Because you have to accessorize. Anyway, Cadola's at work, and I have no idea where Adam is. Okay, so for a little bit of perspective here, okay, this is the base car. So we took it from 335 horsepower and 3,300 pounds. After I took the supercharger off, now we're at 447 horsepower and 2,500 pounds. By way of comparison, okay, this is my Group 3 Viper, okay? It is 678 horsepower, 2,800 pounds. Here's the Group 4 Viper, the Viper that actually is within that little PP thing for that particular race. I've got more horsepower and I'm lighter. With that being said, and you can actually do this as well. You can go through and okay, so the Group 4 car. Okay, now you've kind of seen how I've got that Super B set up. How have they got this set up? Okay. So they got the natural frequency at 3, which is great because they get that high. Because it's a dedicated race car, you'll find that you can't go number for number match up on how things look because, well, yeah. They've got negative camber angle at 3, and they've got toe angle on both. And then 12, 40, and 25. So, let's see. 25, 45, 33. So, let's see how many of those numbers we can get close. This down to 25, I think it was. Fine, I've got it 3-3. I don't know. If I would have been smart, I would have taken a photo of it on my phone. Actually, you know what? I'm gonna leave the frequency a little bit higher in the back than in the front. Actually, probably should. Hmm. Okay, so we got those done. Let's go over to the tuning shop real quick. I want to see if I can get a turbo. Just a plain Jane, regular run-of-the-mill turbo. I know that sounds utterly ridiculous. I'm sorry, did he just say plain Jane turbo? Yes, I did. Yes, I did. Okay, so yeah, none of the turbochargers are available. So I either go with the high-end or the low-end supercharger if I so choose to go that route. Alright. And of course, I'm not keeping like a written record of any of these numbers, so yeah, this could be interesting. Hopefully we're going in the right direction. Alright. Let's go back in. So why am I focusing so much time on the suspension? Because your suspension is actually what keeps the car on the road. One thing I didn't look for, and I figured it would have stuck out to me had it been there, I didn't notice if they have like track bars for the back of this thing to stop the rear end from wrapping around. Theoretically speaking, that shouldn't be an issue on this, theoretically speaking. Because I mean, if you can go through and get the suspension and the traction dialed in to the point to where it's staying put, then it's turning better. It's actually turning better than what it was. Okay, let's see what happens when we stop at the Marshall, shall we? Now, I'm keeping pace with the Cayman, which is actually not what I'm trying to do. Because I'm trying to get in front of that Cayman. And I've got the throttle pad, so this is a battle of, okay, who's got the better top speed. Go, daddy, go! I'm starting to gain on. Not gaining on much, but I am gaining on. I think I could probably break a little bit later on that one, too. Now, in an earlier video, as it pertained to the transmission, I went through and didn't do any of the manual adjustments. I told the computer, hey, this is what I want the top speed to be, so it went through and spread out all the gears equally to go through and... Oh, that was a mistake. Sorry! Okay, so do not wait for the absolute last minute on this one. Or on that stop. I'd say I'd try to draft them, but here's the thing. I'm a brick with wheels. The Challenger's got more aerodynamic components than what this thing does, because, well, you saw it. Take revenge on the Italian, even though I really want to take revenge on the Italian. But we won't take revenge on the Italian. Wait for the little nanobots to fix everything. Now, also, if you look down at the fuel range, fun fact, my range actually hasn't improved by taking the supercharger off. So obviously the supercharger is not draining that much fuel. Because, okay, so actually, I need to qualify that a little bit better. I'm getting a fourth of a lap better without the superchargers on than what I am. So fuel economy is better, but if you look at things in the grand scheme, a half a lap of range still makes me half the pit. So there's actually no benefit. Now, with that being said, overshot it. And no, I was not aiming for him. I swear I wasn't. I just overshot the corner. Wait till we're on the straightaway. That'll be a penalty. Let's add a little bit more power to it. Still on the lean side. We're just not as lean. Let's give it some more petrol down the hole. And on the top end, we are going a wee bit faster. Overshot that a little bit, so I can't wait for the other guy like I normally do. Will you stop smashing that back in? Alright, let's see what we got here. Go, go, gadget fingers. I knew the Porsche was going to do that. I did. Okay. So, we go through and we add a little bit more power to the fuel-air mixture. A little bit more fuel to the fuel-air mixture. Anyway, more power! So, and again, the performance points are only at 641 at the moment. And it's still a very viable car. Okay, so I'm actually kind of happy with that. I really and truly am. Steering wheel, got all the racing stuff on. Now, obviously, as you add toys to your engine and your transmission, you increase the speed, then obviously adjusting the brakes is going to become a lot more important. Again, we just took this back down to see what happens if we stay on the power side of it. Trying to get it to the point. Sorry for the pause. I am actually consciously trying to make an effort not to have as much dead space in the middle of my little theoretically speaking stuff here. So, but yeah, as you add more power and your speed increases, obviously it's either A, going to take more time to stop it, or it's going to require a brake adjustment. Excuse me, Daddy is coming through. That's why I'm kind of all over the place at the moment. Yeah. So, just like in real life, don't touch the walls. Excuse me, coming through, coming through. I think I am going to make some adjustments to the transmission. Bring it down on the top speed. Me and that Subaru have a long history. There are certain AIs that you will go through, and no matter what, every time you turn around, there's a. Yeah, now we're just gonna start. Yeah. Okay, I'm being silly. I'm sorry. Yay, I got a roulette ticket. I have no idea which one. Oh, I got a 4-star roulette ticket. Happy days. Okay, so that was taking the bricks one way. Let's take the bricks the other way, shall we? Let's see what happens. Brakes, brake controller, front rear balance, put it on 4. Alrighty, so there's that. And we were going to adjust this. Okay, so notice how all the bars just, okay, so if I move this, then it automatically kind of goes through and changes all the shift points automatically. Or you can go in and do this again. And yeah, I'm not that smart. I'm really not. I wish I was, but I'm not. Okay, so any brake adjustments does not mess with your performance points. Any transmission adjustments do not mess with your points. But this will mess with your points, and this area will mess with your points. Dun dun dun! Let's see here. Loading. Loading. But I think I can honestly feel comfortably saying I think I've got the suspension where I am wanting it. Because I'm noticing that when I hit the brakes, I'm not ending up with this nosedive. And the car is not nosediving, which is a good thing. It's a penalty. It should be a penalty. And again, when you're in these modes, kind of exceeding the white lines is somewhat okay. Oh, we're gonna, yeah. Okay, you know what? We're gonna cheat. We're gonna retry that. Let's just retry that. And the hurricane got me. Alrighty, so let's see here. Let's go back. No, that's not what I want. That's what I want. So today is my grab this car and mess around and see what we can do day. And then tomorrow I've got manufacturer's cup practice that I'll be doing. Probably stream it for a bit. Probably won't. I don't know. Still on the fence about it. Okay. Let's go back. Let's go back to the garage and take a look at that Viper again. Now, obviously, trying to set this car up like a Viper is really not going to give me 100% benefit, mainly because, we're gonna find out what my roulette ticket is. Mainly because of the aerodynamics, the body shape, the whole kit and caboodle. So let's see here. What have we got for our roulette ticket? I've got the lowest denomination cash. It's okay. Hey, don't get me wrong. It's not like that I'm actually hurting or anything. Yeah. So, as it pertains to what cup is today. Actually, there is no cup today. Today is my try to take an old school muscle car and get it to the point to where it's dominating on a Group 4 track. Okay, so let's see here. 25, 45, 3, 3. So they've got 3 on both. 10 and 20. So 25, 45, 3, 3, 10, 20, 12, 40, 25. And I won't remember most of those numbers when I get over there. And then, yeah. So obviously the Viper is a naturally aspirated. This particular Viper is a naturally aspirated group. Group 4 race car. Okay, so let's go back to this car. Okay, so tuning as it pertains to this simulator is taking a vehicle and making fine adjustments to to go through and get it to perform better than what it is. Okay, so all of that. So according to the numbers, we have the suspension tuned identical to the Dodge Viper on paper. But the Dodge Viper is also extremely aerodynamic. So, as a result, let's see here. Excuse me just momentarily. I'm gonna respond to a text. Work related, sorry. Again, I do apologize for that. Now, the one nice part about it is because of the way that this car is tuned. Okay, and again, at this point in time, if we come over here to the superchargers and all of that, they're all currently uninstalled on the vehicle. On engine tuning, I bored it, I've stroked it, I balanced it, I polished it, and gave it high lift cams. The only thing I haven't done is put the titanium connecting rods and pistons in. The reason why I haven't done that is because apparently that's something that the game has got to give you, which I hope they do give me because it would be kind of interesting to see what kind of effect that would have. So if you notice here, you've got highlighted and non-highlighted sections. Things that are available to me are going to be highlighted. Things not available is stage 4, stage 5 weight reduction. It's not available for this car. High compression pistons, not available for this car. So, and then, yeah, good times. So by adjusting the things that I've adjusted, we've kind of changed the acceleration points, which is a good thing. Apparently all hell is breaking loose at the hospital, but hey, magical little number. I'm off, so I care, but I don't care. Does that make sense? Of course it does. Alrighty, so front rear balance. Huh. That could be interesting. But to add balance to this car, I would have to I would actually have to add weight. And I just put it on a diet. But the benefit to adding weight to it is I can add the weight where I want to add it. So, I don't know. That may be something I come back and I may come back and explore in a bit because that would be kind of interesting. Try to equalize it out to where it's a flat level vehicle. Actually, no, let's leave that where it is. Let's bump that one. Let's make the front end slightly stiffer. Okay. And then what do we do after this? We go to the track. Let's go to the track. Because I want to get to the point to where I'm not on the money grinding. The money grinding isn't just me jumping into pre-made cars. Because you can do that. I mean, you really and truly can, because as you can tell through the racetrack, they have Group 4 race cars on here. I can just go down, spend 350,000 credits, get a race car, and go to town. And there's nothing wrong with that. Just for me personally, now it's gotten to the point of, okay, what can I do to make something better or faster or handle? And I mean, there is a lot of real world applications to this. I mean, they've got entire industries devoted to this. And as silly as it sounds, I get to take part in that in a simulated fashion, which again is nothing more than the price of the game. And by showing you this, I can go through and you don't have to do all the microtransactions. Okay, so like case in point, the Suzuki Swift. I know Suzuki Swift. Come on, people. Anyway, the Suzuki Swift. Group 4 race car, Dodge Viper, Group 4 race car, Corvette C7, Group 4 race car. And you can go through, okay, let's X out of here, and go to Brand Central. And I mean, you can buy those cars. All Group 4 cars, except for one, are 350,000 credits. Then in which case it's just, yeah. Go to America. Ford. Ford's got a Group 4 Mustang. Right there. 350,000. You can buy this, take it into GT shop, customize it paint wise, tire wise, wheel wise, any way you want. And go to town. Ford gives you four Group 3 cars. You've got the Mustang, you've got the Ford GT EcoBoost. Now, I had initially detuned this for that track, because here's the thing, this is a V6. It's the twin turbo EcoBoost V6. Ford GT. That's just blasphemous. And then you've got the Le Mans spec test car, which is the wide body version of their race car. This is the one that I predominantly try to run in sport mode on the daily races against everybody in North America. Some tracks, this car is amazing. Other tracks, not so much. Red Bull Ring, I haven't been able to dial this down yet, so as a result, I'm in the Mustang. The one exception to the $350,000 rule, we come into here. I don't know, the Bugatti is a $350,000 car. Somebody told me it was a million. And I was like, oh, okay. But, I mean, I really can't say anything because I spent $1.6 million on my Ford GT. So, yeah, apparently all Group 4 race cars are $350,000. So, I mean, there are exceptions to that rule. I spent $1.6 million for the Ford GT 40 Le Mans spec race car. Kedal went through and has bought two or three Group 3 race cars out of here. Which kind of make my car seem ghetto. This is a Group 3 race car. It's 1.1. This is a Group 3 race car. It's 11 mil. This is a Group 3 race car. It's 1.8. Yes, I bought the Willys Jeep. Again, if you see the blue book, then that means that you have acquired that car and you own it. I don't own any of these. Although I am a huge Aston Martin fan, and I am going to buy that. The DB5, the James Bond car, people. I'm already maxed out on my collector level, so yeah. Good times, good times. Oh, well, no, children. Okay, so it has been requested that we do one from scratch. And I'm okay with that. So let's do one from scratch. Because again, I still have 5.8 million credits. Every time I win that race, it's 875,000 credits, 825. Okay, so let's see what used cars I've got. Okay, so we are looking for. Actually, you know what? Person who requested this, I'm gonna scroll through the used car lot, okay? And I am going to have you tell me tell me what I'm going to build. Okay, so now with that being said, I will override you if I think it's utterly ridiculous. So we've got a Mini Cooper. I'm not building a Mini Cooper for that track. Scirocco, Ferrari. I've got a bet. Red one, fifth down. I think that is the bet. One, two, three, four, five. Yep. Okay. The Ferrari. Red Ferrari? What red Ferrari? Let's see. Where's the Ferrari at? Obviously. Okay, so you're talking about the Dino 246. Oh, the bet. Okay. Not a problem. I've already built one of these, but that's okay because I can color it any way I want. Okay, so we are going to build a 298 horsepower 1969 C3 Chevy Corvette. Do you want to get in this car now? Yes, I do. Alrighty, so we'll get out of the used car lot. And we're gonna go to the tuning shop. Okay, so before we start adding all the superchargers and all of that, how about we're just gonna build up the engine, okay? So we will board it up. Put the high lift cams in. I'm not even gonna put it on a diet. I'm gonna keep it right at however much it weighs, 3,400 pounds. We'll just keep it at 3,400 pounds. Okay. We'll add the crank. Not any superchargers or anything of that. I am gonna go ahead and add the limited slip. Okay. And then this is where we're really going to start adding stuff to it. Definitely gonna need racing brakes. I don't know why, but I just like the looks of the slotted better than the drilled. Gonna add the brake balance. We are gonna add the totally customizable suspension. And we are going to add the customizable transmission. And of course, we've got tires for days. So the reason why that you do the different tires is for several reasons. One, because some tracks have weather on them. Le Mans has weather on it. That is my preferred track. Sardinia, Cadal's preferred money track, actually doesn't have any weather. It's sunshine throughout all 15 laps. 15 laps, 12 laps. And then Spa, which is the million credit career mode race, it's got weather day and night and sunshine. So that's Cadal. Okay, so well, now children need to stop doing that. I've been doing that a lot. Okay, get that caught up. So we've got the motor, we've got the transmission, we've got the tires, we've got the differential, we've got all of that. Trying to think. Okay, so the individual tune, am I putting a wide body kit on this or am I leaving it just a standard C3? Because Tune's the one who's actually requesting all of this. If you see this in replay, you'll see all of the conversations Tune is trying to get Kitten in here as well. So alrighty. Alrighty, so we are going to leave the car at its actually, I guess I should have let that play. So we're going to leave it at its current height. Although, I am going to add different wheels. These are all the wheels I own. So, I will go through slowly. And then you tell me what wheel I should use. Or if I should try to find another wheel. Now, keep in mind that the wheel will go to a lower profile wheel because, well, again, as I've stated before, tire flex is a real thing. Second from the end. Okay, so this one. Alright. Let's go with that. Now, we are going to we'll go 18s. Because it doesn't have a wide body kit on it, I don't need to worry about. I can just use the standard size. We don't need the wide, and we don't need the wide offset because we don't have a wide body kit on it. Alrighty, so there we go. And then I'm gonna go into the Libri editor. Okay, wait a minute. There may be a change. You want it wide? You want me to widen it? Alrighty, so we will make it wide, and then we'll come back in and put those wheels back on it. Alrighty, and Kitten wants that vet wide. Apparently, Kitten is at work, so she is communicating via text message with my eldest. So, yeah. I'm actually having a lot of fun with this. I am. Car maintenance and service. Okay, so this is where your wide body kits are. So the GT Auto is where you go in and you, and it's highlighted. GT Auto is where you go in and you change your paint color, you change your wheels, you do all of that. But one thing that you also do, work complete, is this is where you go and get your oil change, which is almost kind of funny considering whenever I do it on any of my other cars, the oil change is 400 credits, but here it's 300 credits on the vet. Is that because they're running a sale today, or is it just the vet uses cheaper? Alrighty, so let's see. Now we need to go back into, because we did throw a wide body kit on it. Huh. Hang on a sec. Now, another child is calling. Hello. Hey. Do hamburgers. That's what you want to do.
Well, okay, so. Hamburger means thawed. So.
Oh, sad pandas. Okay, so we went back and put the wide tires on.
What are you doing?
I am doing a live stream where I have been requested to build a car. So.
Do you want me to do
a live
stuff?
No, you're good. I can multitask. I mean, unless you just want to go through and jump on the live stream as well. And
no, I'm at work. So.
Okay, all good.
Yeah. But,
custom parts.
Yeah.
So we need an air dam for the front. We need a wing for the back.
Watch, this reminds me of you trying to explain all stuff in Top Gun, Top Gear to me.
Well, yeah, it's kind of like YouTube's version of a very ghetto Top Gear. Alright.
Well, not ghetto. Or not yet.
Well, I got a question for you. Do you know how to do your mom's tuna casserole? Huh?
She never told me.
Oh, okay. Okay. Right. Are you in a bad cell area? Because it sounds like you're breaking up. Oh, okay.
Yeah, I just stepped outside and I had to go do it from part of it because it was so bad.
So we're actually going to put the individual who is requesting all of this work name on the decal.
Hey, Dad, you want to buy a tree?
Why would I want to buy a tree?
Because my work is selling trees.
Why is your work selling trees?
I don't know. There's like high presses and our emerald green something, so. Want a tree?
Honey, I am
in an apartment.
All right.
You can put the tree inside.
Okay, what kind of tree?
It's one of the, okay, remember in Preston's room, the like little tree bushes we kept seeing?
Uh-huh.
Those.
Oh, okay.
They kind of look like evergreens. Like, they look like a type of evergreen.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Interesting. Right.
I'm outside,
so. Okay. So this library and this car is called Tune.
Oh, hey, look, it's the pumpkins with syphilis. All right.
Yeah.
They look
grateful. This is actually a treat. I got one on the live stream, the other one on the phone.
Which kid is on the live stream?
Huh?
Which kid is on the live stream?
Justin.
Justin.
So, alrighty. So, we've gone through taking a 1969 Corvette C3, giving it a wide body kit, giving it different wheels, giving it a lower profile tire, and then put his name into the windshield banner. Okay, so let's see where this car is at on its base. No.
You're in Texas? We're glad you're from Texas.
True, but with my luck, Simon has been very, very playful lately. He would try to sleep in the damn thing.
Well, you know, he has three legs, Dad.
He does.
Three legs.
That he does. I actually have to change the tires from... Yeah, so not. Realistically, I don't see Simon surviving the end of the year.
Yeah, that's kind of how it is with Zippy right now.
And unfortunately, Simon is a 9-year-old Maine Coon. He's already outlived his life expectancy by a year, because typically it's about 7 to 8 years is how long Maine Coons survive for.
Well, I mean, Cinderella lived like 4 years past her life expectancy.
So... But, I mean, yeah, but here's the thing. Cinderella didn't suffer the trauma of losing a leg or anything of that nature.
No, but she was weird, so.
Right.
Cinderella was the main thing, and weird happened to be on the top of that list.
Oh, good point. Okay, so normally with a bigger car, I start with the hard tires because we are just running a baseline to see where all of these modifications, without any tweaking, the stock modifications, see where they go and where they lead us. Okay, I love you. Okay, bye. Okay. So, it's got fairly good zip. Brakes are good. Oh, why am I lagging? Okay, so the one thing about Gran Turismo 7 and I may or may not have mentioned this before in a previous live stream, is the fact of it does require an internet connection. Oh! Okay, so the rear end is a little on the loose side at the moment. Let's see what we can get out of the top speed. Rear end is really loose. Okay, so right now, my top speed in this car Okay, so top speed is 161 miles an hour. I believe this is the highest that number got. Oh, well, unfortunately, whenever we did the tap and bang, it kind of messed up the front end, so... Okay, so with no fuel saving, no nothing, you're looking at 2 laps worth of fuel, and... First fix itself, and it is all over the place. Okay, so let's start adjusting. Alrighty. So, one of the first things you want to do is improve the aerodynamics. Yeah, we put the air dam on in the front, and we put the wing on the back, and that kind of helps. Some, but we need to do more. So, body height currently is at 105. We're going to drop that down to 100. Front and rear. Make it nice and level. Anti-roll bar. Yeah, that. Mm-hmm. So we're going to take that to a 5. No, we're going to take that to a 6. We're going to take that to a 5. Alrighty, so dampening compression ratios, we're going to leave those right where they're at. Now, with race cars, which is what we're turning this into, your natural frequency or your spring rate is always higher. So we are going to dramatically change that to 275. We're not going to max it out, but... We are going to add quite a bit. Negative camber angle. We're going to bump that to 1 because we're going a lot faster than what toe angle. We're going to give it a smidge of toe. Let's go to 0.1. Bump that up to 30. And then we're going to adjust the transmission. Top speed of 220 miles an hour actually netted us a top speed of 160 miles an hour. So we are going to bump that up to 300 and see what that does. Brakes were actually working really good. But with that being said, we're just going to add a smidge more brake to the back. So, now, keep in mind, we haven't put this thing on a diet yet, okay? So, we're going to do that, see how that works. Still going to stay on the medium tire. And then, yeah. See how the Tune Mobile does now. Tune Mobile. Alrighty. Still leaving it full gas. Now, during a race, what I would do is, because I've ran this race so many times, okay, definitely no brake bob like we were seeing before. So that's good. But when it would actually come time for a race, we'll just make those cones disappear. You would actually adjust your fuel mixture. In a perfect world, what you're going for is you want 3 laps. The reason why is because, again, I've ran this race so many times. On lap 3, at the end of lap 3, you're going to be in rain. So you're going to need to go into the pits. So if you can schedule your tire change and your fuel at the same lap, that would be best. Now our top speed is considerably higher. Like, so much higher that I am not going to be able to see it before we have to stop. And again, this is all just motor and transmission tweaks with suspension tweaks. If your suspension is sloppy, it will slow you down. Turning's good. Let's see how many positions we can gain with this setup on a first lap. I'm still looking for the same brake markers as I am in any other car, mainly because those are the brake markers I use. Now, when you start adjusting your fuel air mixture, that is going to affect your top speed. Obviously, if you've got less fuel going into the engine, it's not going to be quite as powerful. So, oh, I got that way wrong. That was my fault. Bad decision. That's okay, because me and the Spaniard there also have a long history in this race. So we started in 20th, because in this mode you always start in 20th. Waiting for my back wheel to fix itself, which should be any second now. Okay, that was not a controlled entry into that at all. So, yep, I got lucky. And off to the wizard we are. Started in 20th currently. Can we get in the top 10? Ideally the top 5, but can we get in the top 10? Now, during this section, you've got one of two options, and it's not just this car, but any car. You can do the whole tapping the brake thing that you're seeing them do, or you can just kind of feather the throttle throughout everything. Unfortunately, I damaged the nose of my car. Can I get top 10? If need be, I will dive bomb these people. Oh, lordy. Alrighty. So, on the first lap, we were able to gain through half the field. So, we were gaining on everybody by just doing I wasn't meaning to rear end everybody. So you can go through, and all we did was we adjusted. What all did we mess around with? We messed around with the limited slip. Actually, no. I didn't. So we just messed with the suspension, and we just messed with the transmission. Because again, we don't have any about this stuff. Okay, all we did was just the engine stuff. We haven't reduced the weight. We haven't done any of that. We adjusted the brake ballast. So, and that's all we did. And we took it from a stock standard 400 performance points car to a 625. Now, let's see. Okay, we're not going to do anything else to the motor because there's nothing else to do to the motor. But let's see what happens when we put old girl on a diet. Or put old boy on a diet, since the car is named after my eldest. So, while we are making our way to the tuning shop, okay, so let's start the thinning out process. How far down can we actually take this vehicle? Now, as you are making things lighter, you are going to need to stiffen it up so that it is able to, stage three. So this particular car, the skinniest you can make it is a stage two weight reduction. And then we went through and also stiffened the body up, stiffened the frame. So now we can go through and I need to see something real quick. So your screen's going to turn blue for just a moment. Let's see if I can join a party. There we go. Alrighty, so everybody on the live stream who finds this later, tune is now in the party chat. Well, wait a minute. You actually may not be able to hear him because he may not have his permissions on.
No, it's allowed.
Oh, is it now?
Yeah, I just checked.
Well, there you go. See?
Oh, look at that. Look at that.
Well, there you go.
Y'all thought I was fucking nuts.
No, I
Y'all
never would.
Y'all crazy.
Never once implied you were knuckin' futs.
Okay. Right now I'm trying to fucking clean my watch because...
Boy, I hope it's past your time limit. Just saying. Right. If your stream isn't long enough for your that time limit, there was like three F-bombs there in like 30 seconds.
Oh no, it was way... It was way past. He's been at this for like an hour.
Oh, okay, perfect.
Okay.
I'm going
as
to...
long as you don't start off in like the first 30 seconds, then you're good.
Can't drop the F-bomb inside 3 minutes.
Oh, it's 3 minutes? I thought it was 30 seconds.
On a live stream, it's 3 minutes. Okay, so what we did was we went through and we joined Cadol, Tune, and Etowon.
I think you should join in on this debauchery.
I don't want. Alright. Oh no, I'm on most of my live streams. And you go through and you watch the replays.
I'm talking about they should do what I'm having you do. Alright, so which car did I pick? Because it was a little hard to see. I know I picked a Corvette.
Picked the 1969 Corvette C3. Okay. Now, there were actually three C3 Corvettes released in 69. Okay, you had your base burner model, which is the one you picked because that's the only one that was available. You had a mid-range, and then they had one that had 428 horsepower. It was under-marketed. They only made like 250 of them.
The one you want to get your hands on.
And I've got one.
In real life.
I don't have one.
Just saying.
But it was the racing Corvette. Didn't come with a radio, didn't come with AC. It was purely a track car that you could pick up. But again, Chevy only made 250 of them.
All right.
Now, what I would love to see happen, which unfortunately it can't happen because it's not available anymore, is I would love to see Cadal do this with, like, the judge.
The judge is my next project.
I was just going to say each of you pick each other's car and do it. Go full Top Gear on this shit.
No, the judge is my next car, and I think I'm going to hunt down a picture of Judge Dredd and put it on the inch bonnet.
Oh, okay. Okay, so I'm leaving the fuel mixture as standard, everything as was before, because we're actually not going to complete a race yet. But as you can tell by me dropping almost 1,000 pounds off this thing, it is considerably faster. Downside to it is it's also a little bit more finicky because there's not as much weight keeping the power down on the ground.
I was going to say, I hope it handles better than it did. Because, good God, when you first took that thing on the road as is, yikes. That thing handled horribly.
RJ?
So, whereas before, on the first lap, I was able to get into the top 10... I'm on the first long straightaway, and I'm already at position 8.
7.5. Okay.
And because it's lighter, it stops a little bit better. I can't hit the same brake marker that I do in, like, the GT40, which, again, is just a detuned, Group 3 car.
Yeah.
But, I mean, it will get up and it will the scoop. Like, to the point of I'm taking a tenth of a second off at a time. The distance between me and first place is plummeting at the moment.
I will return.
Alrighty. Because it is lighter, it does get a little bit better fuel economy. It's still not to the point to where you can get 3 laps out of it completely wide open. But it appears that I've added about
a third of a lap to each chain pull.
Okay, that's good, right?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. Alright, so...
Now, I have 1 through 7 in front of me, so let's see if I can catch these guys and pass them.
That won't take long.
Well, no, because unfortunately I had a half-second penalty, so that kind of slowed me down a little bit.
Yeah.
But again, I'm currently in position 7, whereas at the end of the first lap with the previous setup, when this thing was at full weight, I was only able to get into the top 5, or top 10.
I have 10 different types of tea to choose, 11 different types of tea to choose from here. Oh my god.
And we're in the top 5. And at the end of the first lap, we are in 4th place.
Well, 4th with an asterisk because... Alright, so... I'm gonna just... While you're doing that, I'm gonna run by you all the fucking teas I have on hand right now. So, I have 3 different types of Earl Grey, mm-hmm. 1 Bigelow, 1 Teavana, and then 1 from Harney and Sons. Really like their tea. I've got 2 different types of English breakfast here, 1 from Harney and Sons, 1 from Bigelow. I've got pomegranate white tea, I have energized matcha, I have Japanese sencha tea, I have fucking orange passion fruit, I have cherry blossom, and I have this mountain blackberry tea that's actually not that bad.
Good deal.
So I'm trying to figure out what the hell do I want to drink.
Well, you know me and Earl Grey, so... And we're in first place.
I thought you preferred English breakfast more than Earl Grey.
No, God, no.
Alright, I'm gonna do the Earl Grey Supreme. Just because of the fact that it's got higher quality, it has higher quality tea leaves, and it also comes in a little silk pouch, which means you get more of the whole leaves of tea, which means it's more reusable.
Hmm.
So, that one, because a normal tea bag will get you, like, what, 2 cups of tea? Before it's, like, just not even worth using anymore. The silk pouches are like, it's loose leaf tea just in the fucking pouch. Mm-hmm. So you can get like 3 or 4 cups out of just one of these. So I don't rip the damn bag of the top of it. That is dope. Okay.
What does my weather radar look like at the moment?
For the game or for you?
For the game.
I don't know.
I just pulled it up. It's all good. I got it. Still clear at the moment. Got a Suzuki Swift that is currently in first place.
That still kills me. Well, here comes the rain.
Which means you're gonna have to hit the pits and put on rain tires.
Actually, yeah, because that screen is all rain.
Oh, I'm seeing it. Alright, so if it handles like piss in the dry, it's going to handle worse in the wet.
Well, that's just it. It's not handling bad right now. I mean, it's a little bit looser because I need to tighten everything up because I made the car lighter. But,
Don't you also need to fiddle with some differentials?
Actually, no. The differential, the aftermarket differential on the stock settings feel really good.
Oh, alright. Trying to think of what else that I'm aware of that you could possibly do to try and tune it outside of the suspension, the brakes, and the air intake.
I mean, other than going through and putting a supercharger on it, because unfortunately this particular motor isn't got a turbocharger available for it. So it's either you supercharge it or you leave it stock.
Okay.
So. So yeah, this is the second 69 Corvette C3 that I built. Just this one's got your name on it.
Okay, and I take it this one's also being managed a little differently?
Well, no, I mean, it's just, it was one of those that, because of your inquiry, now people can see you don't have to throw a supercharger on everything. So, don't get me wrong, it makes it fun. So, but we've got intermediate rain tires on, which will give us a little bit better grip. The thing to really pay attention to that is a little bit. But a lot of it also has to do with the fact of when you start doing this, and you decide you want to do this aspect of the races instead of just going down and buying your race car, it's a learning curve, and it's a lot of trial and error. I just went through and I've done a couple of these. So I went through and was kind of like, okay, well, let's start with these guidelines to see where, because I've done this on other cars and it's worked out fine. And each car is different. I mean, this maximum or minimum weight that you can get this down to is lower than what I can get the Challenger down to, which is heavier than what I can get the Super B down to. So, and then Cody and I can both attest to the fact of you kind of drive a little bit different when the track is wet, even with the wet tires. The wet tires doesn't give you 100% full throttle again, as if you were in the dry. So,
what track are you even using to test this?
Le Mans.
Oh, so you're gonna run the full 20, laps in this thing?
Actually, for this endurance race, it's only the most we've been able to get out of this track is 7.
Why that?
Because it's only 30 minutes, and it takes, right now, the fastest lap is 4:45.
Ah,
which even on rain tires on wet track, I should be able to beat that time. Should be able to.
Alright, is this just the fastest lap for, like, this race, or is it the fastest lap you've done?
Oh, no, this is just the fastest lap for this race. Cody, or Cadal, has gotten his fastest lap down to, like, 410. My fastest lap is, like, 411. Okay. So...
So, how many resources did you go through to, like, understand the tuning aspect of this game?
Well, the game comes with a book or a website called Beyond the Apex. So, they've got good reading material there. And then, of course, you've got a couple of guys on YouTube that will do this. I tried watching one guy, but he was explaining things in, like, the really scientific form. So, I mean, it
was,
wasn't
like, really beginner-friendly.
No. His YouTube video was not user-friendly at all, which is why whenever I've done this on live streams, I've tried to really break it down into, like, the simplest terms that I can. And again, I'm not a tuner. I'm not. I'm just somebody farting around with it.
Well, I mean, that's how hobbies are built. Somebody fucks around with something, they like it, keep at it, and then, I mean, not in the case of Gran Turismo, but that's how people turn hobbies into jobs.
Right. Oh no, there are people that have turned this into a job. Cadal and I both will watch a live stream for a guy called Kai25. He's based out of the UK. He does this for a living.
What, just tunes cars?
No, he does YouTube for a living.
Well, yeah, that's how most YouTubers are.
Not me. I work in a lab.
Yeah, but you like the lab.
I do.
Although, I'm sure if somebody offered you a race engineering position...
I would have them drug tested, because I'd be like, you know how much of a dumbass? I'm a veteran, okay? I'm the quintessential trial and error guy.
Yeah, well, so that... you also did aviation mechanics a little bit, so...
Mm-hmm.
Which means you have some understanding of basic engineering.
Yes.
Knows what a wrench looks like.
And a rivet gun.
All he's got to know is where to put those on the car, then boom.
And I can mix me up some epoxy beautifully.
That's more handyman.
So, yeah. Nah, I figured I'd just go ahead and run this entire race. And again, this car has no supercharger on it, no turbocharger on it. It's just been bored up. Bored up and shined pretty. Blowing through the intermediate tires too quickly, so be able to get another lap out of them. That way, when I go back into the pits for the last time, I will really be able to go ham.
Yeah. God, I wish I was not sick. Sorry to pull you away from fine tuning whatever the other car was.
Oh, the Super Meat? Oh, no, it was great. I mean, it was actually one of those that, I mean, I was happy to do it.
Yeah, because originally I thought you were just going to pimp out that Aston Martin you bought. And then once you decided to let me pick a car, it's like, all right, we're in business.
Yeah.
But I got to ask, why the hell weren't you going to work on a Mini?
I'm not putting a Mini Cooper on this track. There are certain cars that I am not going to do. Okay, a Mini Cooper, Suzuki Swift. Okay.
Why, because it'd be unfair to the other players, even though they're computers?
No, because I have a set of balls. I'm not, no. I'm not doing that. Mini Cooper's a chick's car.
A Mini Cooper is a car that is dripped in heritage and prestige.
Okay.
No, no, children.
I'm sorry, the Super B. How many WRC titles does it have? Yeah, that's what I thought.
Well, you see, and that's the appeal of it.
What, the fact that you can't rally in it?
Pretty much.
Well, you can, but...
it wouldn't go well. I'm pretty sure his fucking lift-up Jeep would do better on a rally circuit than a Super B.
Yeah, I'd be inclined to agree with you, but, I mean, my Wrangler is meant to do that.
Yeah, and also stop for gas, like, a quarter of the way in. Is there any way you can, like, just get rid of that lift kit on that damn thing?
Yeah, I can take it off, take it back to stock Hive.
Would it work better for your gas?
No. Here's the thing, Jeeps are inherently horrible on gas mileage.
Yes,
always have
they
been.
Are. They
always will be.
The only time Jeeps are good on gas is when you are 4x4ing.
Yep. But that's what they were designed for. I mean, they were purpose built.
You will not get highway mileage in a Jeep ever.
Nope.
Part about being sick. I can't remember where the hell I said shit.
So, get this thing into the pit, turn the fuel map all the way down to full power, and then...
try and finish out the lap strong?
Well, it's not so much that I'm finishing out the lap strong, it's just typically on my last lap, I always go full power. And then I will have soft racing tires on this. So it will be power, 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 power.
Okay.
Give me the racing soft, please, sir.
Does it stop raining?
Yeah. All right.
Wait, but wouldn't you want to
keep and this is what your car looks like coming down the lap, or coming down the pit lane.
Stick with the rain tires if you're still driving on wet tarmac?
Well, okay, so here's the thing, and this is the thing in real life as well. The raced parts of the track will dry faster, and they will stay dry longer during wet conditions.
Alright.
So... whereas, yes, the track is still wet. As long as I stay on the racing line, I'll be fine. Now, with that being said, have I always been fine? Nope. Like there, I went through, inadvertently got into a little bit of the wet stuff, and spun.
And that penalizes you.
Well, yeah, because it damages your car. And the reason why it damages your car so hard, because it didn't used to be that way. When I first got this game, we didn't have this problem. The reason why we have this problem is because some genius thought it was a good idea to go to High Speed Ring or whatever track it was that we went to, and people were wall riding. So what Poly finally did was, they were like, okay, fine, you want a wall ride? We'll penalize you for it. Downside to it is when they penalized you for it, they penalized it throughout the game in all modes. So now it's to the point of, if your car touches the wall in any way, shape, form, or fashion, you end up with damage.
Well,
and typically it takes 11 seconds for the little nanobites or bots or whatever you want to call them to repair themselves.
Yeah.
But while you're waiting for that to fix itself, it goes through and it limits what you're able to do speed-wise, handling-wise, cornering-wise, everything-wise. It's the bad bad.
Aren't there some concepts for cars with self-repairing bodywork?
I'm pretty sure somebody thought of that. Or started working on it, or whatever you want to call it.
You really gonna let him take you like that?
Well, I had to serve a half second penalty, so.
Do we just like slow down for half a second and then go back?
You see, all I'm trying to do is trying to get over the start finish line and over the course of the next minute so I can have one more lap. Because I know it sounds utterly ridiculous, but it's true. I want that other lap.
You draft this man. Draft his ass like there's no tomorrow.
Nope. That's a penalty. Ah, screw it. That's a penalty, too. The nice part about it is, it's a 5.5 second penalty.
Oh, God. How are you supposed to serve that?
When I come up to the penalty line.
Okay, so how the hell did you just walk away with 5 second penalty?
Because I cut the hell out of two corners.
I was like, yeah, you cut the corners, but I didn't know it was that severe.
Yeah.
Cool.
I think he's concentrating.
Huh? He said RJ and muted.
Yeah. I heard, hey RJ, and then mute. God, where's this damn penalty line now?
Oh, it's like way the ballistic down here, which is fine because that 5.5 second penalty is actually going to come closer to about a 9 second loss. So I'm trying to get a 9 second gap between me and second place.
Alright.
That way I'm not having to race so aggressively to win this thing, because right now I'm on course to win this thing. I know, right now, with the way the time splits are happening, I'm 12.5 seconds faster than the fastest time until this penalty. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Fortunately, I was able to open up about a 9.5 second gap between me and the guy in second. So, this race is mine, barring me doing something extremely stupid. So, we spent 47,000 on the car itself, and then probably spend about another
300,000 to 350,000. Still 7 seconds ahead. on all of the modifications that we did. And again, that was like no supercharger, no nothing. It's just suspension, transmission, tires, and limited slip. Widen the body, put it on a diet, and then, yeah.
So it's cheaper to just tune a car than try and buy a car that you actually...
Well, all depends upon what car it is. I mean, again, this was on sale on the used car lot. So... And those efforts netted 825,000 credits.
All right. And
which takes me back up to 6.2 mil.
All right. But what are you looking at in regards of, like, final touches to this car?
Things that I would do,
Nothing break, I'd be back.
Alrighty. I would do a little bit more fine tuning with the suspension. I would do a little bit more fine tuning with the limited slip. And I had to cut those corners because I dropped so much weight. And I really haven't made any adjustments to the suspension at all. All we did was drop the weight and then put it back on the track. Just with the way that it was behaving, I went ahead instead of doing the one lap to see, okay, how many positions can we change? I felt good about the car and felt good about the race, so I just raced it. Yeah, because by the time I went through and passed that BMW, I was in eighth place. And then once I hit the top five, I was like, yeah, let's go ahead and finish this thing out. And then by the time that I hit this straightaway again on the next lap, I was in the lead. Now, again, whenever you do changes to the vehicle, weight-wise, performance-wise, speed-wise, whatever, you're going to have to modify the way that you drive ever so slightly, which is a real fancy way of, you need to figure out where your new brake point is, because it's going to change.
Alright. So you basically have to relearn the track.
Yeah. But, I mean, it was one of those, I knew I had the power. I knew I had everything that I needed to do to make it a successful race. Mainly because I had tuned this car to that point.
Alright.
Now, with that being said, will I run this car again? Probably not. Realistically. Mainly because... actually, let me qualify that a little bit better. Will I go through and finish fine-tuning it? Yeah, I'll finish fine-tuning it. But once it's fine-tuned, will this be the car that I go to for this track? No. But it was a good, educational opportunity, because then you know that you can go through and, now, I mean, if you absolutely positively, say you only had enough money to build this car in its basic form the way that we had it before we took the weight off, so on and so forth, could I have won that race? Back when this thing was heavier, yeah, I probably could have. Proper race strategy, because again, I know Le Mans at the end of lap 3 or sometime during lap 3, whether it be at the beginning, the middle, or the end, you're going to have rain. In this case, it actually started at the beginning of lap 3. I was by the pits, so I could dip into the pits and put the wet tires on and go to town. Which is exactly what I did. And then I ran 3 laps on the intermediate wets
which gave the track time to get wet, dry off a little bit. That way when I came back in for the second pit stop, then I could put the fastest tire available, which is the Racing Soft. It's got the least rolling resistance, it's got the maximum grip, it's got everything. Downside to it is you go through them so quickly. So, but I could go in and yeah. And just like before, whereas previous I was saying it was the Viper because I was in a Challenger or a Super B, that Corvette up front is probably going, okay, who let the old man on? And the funny part about it is the vet wasn't the fastest car on that lap. No.
Huh.
Yeah, because there's a car in front of both of us. That little Suzuki Swift. And yeah, by way of comparison to the new vet to the classic vet, yeah, I look like a little go-kart. Even with the wide body kit on it. Then yeah, by the end of that straightaway, I was in the lead because I blew by the Suzuki. So I mean, and that's the one good thing about Gran Turismo 7 is it gives you multiple different options. You can go through and you can run a proper race car. You can build a car. You can. You can get out of this simulator anything that you want to put into it.
All right.
And I mean, you know me, Dad's been a gearhead your entire life, and actually prior to the bulk of my life. Just this gives me the ability, whereas yes, it is virtual, I can do the silly stuff. Because, I mean, all of the stuff that you go through and you stop and you think about doing to vehicles, yeah, that's when I totally missed my breakpoint. Rivers! Dude, you scratched my chrome. Anyway, anything that you've thought about doing in real life, you can actually do virtually. If I'm actually going to be able to see the animation of the headlights popping up, or if they're going to be already popped up in one of the scenes.
If they let you see it, that'd be a nice touch.
I know.
and you got to see him pop up. And then the two nomadic pit crew getting ready to do some work.
Wait, you called your pit crew the two nomadic?
No, I called your pit crew the two nomadic, because again, this is your car. So.
Oh. I don't know, I thought they were yours because they're fucking purple and not red like the car. I don't know.
And what's Kitten's favorite color?
Purple, but they've been purple for fucking every stream I've seen.
Yeah, and why is that?
Because every woman in your life has her favorite color purple.
Exactly. So I got everybody covered by just that one gesture.
Yeah, but your grandson loves blue and yellow. Where's the representation for your grandson?
And then we went back out.
So I take it some of these cars that you tune, like, never see an online race.
No, I can't take that on an online race.
Can't
that bet will...
Disc golf ball.
That bet will be on career mode. Same with the Challenger, same with...
The Viper.
Yeah. Well, no, the Viper... My Group 3 and Group 4 race cars are
race cars.
Yeah. And that's how that breaks down. So, like, this week... Okay, so last week I was a B-rated driver. And even when it was week before last when I got my B ranking back... I said, even though that I'm a B-rated driver, I'm still a solid C. Because, well, I went backwards again.
That's okay. I'm still a solid E.
That's only because he doesn't race the races.
Oh, no, I spent too much time cutting the grass. I is practicing my lawnmowering skills.
Come practice at my house.
So, no.
So, Dad, would you recommend that little challenge I gave you?
Yeah, but I mean, where we would run into problems at is there's no way to stream all three. I mean, we would. Yeah, I could stream the race because I could go into a private lobby, set it up, and then. Do it that way, but as it pertains to like watching everybody build their cars, there would be no way that we could stream that. I mean, we could stream my end,
And then I'd have to stream my end, and Adam would have to stream his end, and then
you
we'd
guys
have
would
to...
No, if you guys were to do it all three, you'd have to take turns share playing. Like, this wouldn't be a you guys do it on stream, it'd be just a hey, we're bored, let's fuck around kind of thing. What I was just talking about in general, Dad, was, like, just picking up a car and then, like, tuning it up. Like, just, like, having somebody say, hey, here's what I want you to try and work on. Like, I wasn't really thinking of the whole having you three pick each other's cars, because that would, honest to God, just be fucking hysterical.
That would be funny.
Just have Cody and Adam pop into your stream real quick, be like, all right, you two, pick my car. And then see how long it takes for them to come to an agreement on said car.
Probably wouldn't take long.
Let's try that again. Missed my brake marker.
Okay, settings.
I see. This is... one of this week's daily races. this week's daily races are Red Bull Ring in Group 3.
Frickin' Fuji.
Fuji International in Group 1.
Frickin' 3 week Fuji. Alexander. Come on now, there's no need to be that close to the TV. If you want to sit closer to the TV, take your chair out from behind the table and put your chair in front of the table and then watch from there. Why would you just take this one? Or you could just use stools, but you don't need to be right in front of the, that's still right in front of the TV, buddy. Back up like 3 feet. That was like 3 inches. That was like 3 more inches, so you got a half a foot. Okay, that's good enough. 3 inches out of shit. Sure, ready for what? Oh, nice kick. Hoot! The kick saw around nowhere. Scared of banded lobsters.
Calluses?
The guy in the video with their watch. They hit him with a stink bomb and told him to go have a shower, and then as he got in his bathroom to have a shower, they had the three market lobsters sitting in the shower with bands on them. Okay, Alec, or Kaylin. Hey! Hey!
Draw!
Just to see if I can.
Oh yeah, isn't manufacturer tomorrow?
Yeah.
Yes.
Well, Dad, doesn't that mean you need to start getting some practice in?
No, he thinks he's good enough.
No, yeah, I'll do.
Not that BMW.
Well, I have no idea what you're talking about. I was highly debating on switching to BMW.
Well, then switch to BMW.
Fuck that shit.
Then why the fuck you bring it up, you coward?
For something to do. I wouldn't go to BMWs because I don't like BMW. I'd go to Aston Martin first.
Yes, I don't know if I'm going to go Ford, Dodge, or Jaguar. Those are the ones that
you... Jaguar, you seem to do good with the Jags.
I do.
And there's no no shame in driving a Jaguar.
Well, there's no shame in driving a Ford or a Dodge.
No. BMW, you might be a little bit Nancy. So if you drive an Aston Martin or a Jaguar, you got like Bond motif status going on. You drive the BMW, you got Jason Statham.
Nothing wrong with Jason Statham.
Transporter. Terrible.
No, he was an Audi.
He was an Audi, yeah. Sorry. Okay, Transporter 3. He was a BMW. And that's not even Jason Statham. You have his cheap counter knockoff that can't fight. Hey, did you just say Kanye West? That'd be funny. Add one.
White one.
Oh, you're a jerk.
What? What?
I was about to say, why is he a jerk?
Mez, you're no better.
What are you talking about? We've been nothing but loving and supportive. How are we jerks?
That's a goddamn lie.
I know, right? Posting a 131 and a 132 that I just can't catch. And yes, Island's a jerk too.
Well, I guess you better practice some more, huh?
I am. I'm getting there. I did knock myself down to fucking 132.7. Which is 4 seconds from my starting time. Okay, go bingle bangle in the kitchen.
Can I go bingle bangle in the kitchen?
That'd be a good idea, too. You could bingle bangle up in your room all you want.
I mean, if you bingle bangled up in the kitchen, then they'd have to, like, sanitize everything with fire.
I think it's my kitchen.
If Adawan's bingle banging, well, you mean.
You know.
Well, we have to have EMS on standby.
What the hell was that?
That was Adawan, the sound of Adawan bingle bangling.
You guys are jackasses.
Luckily, there's an EMT in this party, so
that was good. Complete true setup delivered. I'm fucking gone.
Oh, fuck. I dropped a fuck phone.
That's not upstairs. That's on the stairs.
Are they using the pots as instruments?
No, my stainless steel mixing bowls.
Oh, those aren't cheap.
I could care less. Saves them from putting holes in my walls. Bang them whenever they want.
Alright, you know, fair enough.
I mean,
I think Leon did the whole pots and pans as instruments for like maybe a week, and then he was just done. After that.
Yeah. Kids did it for like a day here, and then they were done. But every once in a while, they get a sense of nostalgia, and they want to do it again.
I have half a damn mind to just make some brownies.
Are they edibles?
No.
And why are you making brownies?
You can't eat them. Why would you make them?
Walked right into that one.
From both of us, no less. Yep, and just as I got my car straightened out, gone again.
Oh, look at that.
I am 26 seconds behind now. Two jokes. Oh, I knew that was bound to happen. Bang, bing, bang, bing, bang, bing, bang, bing. Ow! Apparently she wanted to use Alex's bow.
That's...
Or wanted to use Alex?
Or Alex, period. Good thing is he's got a door shut.
Yeah. Nope. Oh, I didn't overshoot. What the fuck am I doing?
Yeah, ooh, 0.5 gain. Not on my overall time, but.
Well, 132s, 133s, that's all I'm pulling out today.
Okay, got that taken care of. Fucky. Hello.
No, goodbye.
No. I'm trying to.
All right, that was a good solo practice.
trying to set something up on Destiny, and I'm having a hell of a time trying to make sure I have everything that I need on hand. That way I don't have to go and mindlessly try
farm shit.
Yeah.
You should message Zach.
Oh god, I haven't talked to Zach in over a year.
Pretty sure he's on and on Destiny.
He was last when I come on.
Do I even have Zach on this account?
Probably not.
No, I've got him on my other account. Oh. Oh, because fucking, why is there a picture of a buffalo under the St. Louis Arch? Alright, Murder's supposed to wake up from his nap over an hour ago, and we were supposed to go run a few things, but Jackass is still asleep, so I'm trying to find a way to kill some time. That's a more even. Do I want a more even split? Actually, I think I do. Oh, that's good too.
Yeah. Oh, stupid penalty. ...1.4 seconds behind my time because of a penalty. What? No, you can't go outside. No, you can't drum outside. I would have bought you a drum kit last year for Christmas, but... You can't keep your room clean.
You had other plans for your money.
No, that had nothing to do with the RCMP. That was his older sister.
Ah.
And it wasn't the RCMP, it was the whole lawyer. I could have represented myself and probably saved a couple thousand dollars.
Could have had Adewan represent you. Probably would have done it for a 12-pack of beer.
No, because Adewan would have... Being the type of friend Edwin is the type of friend I would have been. It would have been like, ladies and gentlemen of the jury, before you stands a man who, well, I mean, technically was innocent, but I've known him for a while, and he is a little bit of an instigator, so I mean, did they
Edwin
go too far?
Got there, yes. And I would have been in jail for 4 years.
Please,
take him away and lock him up, the key. Lock him up and throw away the fucking key.
Just walk in there and be like, ladies and gentlemen,
he's guilty.
Of the jury. He's guilty, eh?
I know, we didn't go to trial.
Then he walk up to you afterwards, be like, you owe me $42,000 in legal fees, eh?
You know what I mean? Hey.
Yeah.
Hey.
You can always tell when an American's trying to impersonate a Canadian because they always put the A's in at the wrong spot, eh?
We really do. But it was just to get the joke across. So.
It makes it funny when I hear an American doing it, because then it sounds like the Moose and the Caribou from The Great Outdoors.
I know what you're talking about.
Might be Alpha and Omega. Yeah. Might be Brother Bear, too. It's one of those shows, one of those cartoon kid shows.
Let's see, Brother Bear was definitely one of those. Fuck.
I was a big, a fucking dumbass goose and a supposedly smart duck in it, too, that really weren't overly smart. And, of course, they were representing the United States at the finest.
The logical version of Pinky and the Brain?
Pretty much.
Wait, besides, Canadians really don't say A a lot unless they're from, like, Newfoundland.
Nope, then it's bye.
No, that's bye?
Yeah, like, bye. You know what I mean, bye?
They don't say A at all.
No, it's, no. No. A is more of a central and it's like people from Ontario and Saskatchewan generally tend to say A quite a bit more than. Most other provinces. Prince Edward Island, you get stuff like up east.
Up east? Okay.
Yeah, you know, I gotta go visit my cousins up east.
Well, they actually live southwest.
No, they live just straight east, but...
Alright, it's time for a fucking Canadian mannerisms lesson.
Oh, it depends on the province. Do you want to start with Alberta? Add on, take the show.
Please enlighten us.
On that note, silence, I hear crickets.
Ah, the only quiet Canadians out there.
The crickets?
No, Ottawa. And yeah, the crickets.
Shit.
I don't want concentrating.
I was gonna say, I don't want quiet. That's an oxymoron.
No, just like Cadal being quiet whenever he's concentrating. So are you on a race or are you still doing time trial?
I got 29 seconds left. Whoops. And damn, I would have had 3 seconds cut off my time there had I not been into the fucking gravel. And I got 16 seconds left. I better pause. I'm not going to pause it.
11 seconds left. 10 seconds left. 9 seconds left. 8 seconds left.
I'm just going to let my car idle into the gravel and I'm going to go check on my supper.
I am going to do some car shopping.
Oh, and what are we shopping?
We're going to do some car shopping.
Well,
Oh my god.
Today on stream, Mez is going to tune a Mini.
No.
I already done that.
I am car shopping in the respect of... I am...
Today on Mez's stream, I've already tuned a Mini, and it's like almost 500 horsepower.
Actually, you know what?
Today on Mez's stream, nobody fucking asked.
Yes, the 911 is starting to take over. Ooh, ninth place start.
Well, 911 has always taken over at some point in every race since the 119 update. At some point during the week, I am actually going to get into a Roo.
See
how it does on Red Bull.
Oh, what kind of Roo?
WRX.
A kangaroo. Oh.
No. He's going into Red Bull with the kangaroo. I was thinking he might try a Subaru.
GT 300.
Alright on, I got a totally different lobby today. God, those guys I raced with yesterday were a bunch of jackasses.
What happened?
But they were a bunch of jackasses. It seemed to be the dirtiest lobby I've seen in a week.
Okay.
God, they had no etiquette at all. Bump, bump, smash, bump, bump, smash. Bump, bump, push off the road.
Not even a story.
Okay, so apparently you can brake later in the WRX.
Made 75 on the first turn. Second gear, 75, it's just in between the 150 somewhere.
Just punch it at the apex coming out.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah. Serious.
Me too. Just make sure you upshift as soon as you punch it, because if you don't, you're fucking going around circles.
Yeah, again, automatic transmission.
Again, automatic transmission. Start shifting.
Thank you.
Okay, alright, I guess this actually kind of works as anyways.
Are you okay, baby girl?
What's wrong, little one? What an alien, you young man.
Man, Coaster needs to be, like, gone.
So, Dad, do you even sign with a new manufacturer yet?
No, I gotta wait for the season and then wait for the window to open up to do it.
What, like an open enrollment thing?
Yeah.
How much longer you got in the season?
Three more weeks. Races?
Okay, so in the Mustang, I was running 132s, and this, I'm running 135s. Although this lap may be different.
Fuck! Kerr, go backwards! Thank you!
Yeah, that was horrible. On the next lap.
Made it 4 to 5 laps before I spun out. I would much prefer to spin out on the first lap.
Thank you.
Okay, so since I'm still streaming, I guess I should kind of somewhat explain what I'm doing. Okay, so every track has got its quote-unquote dominant card that they use. Certain manufacturers you will always see. Of course you will always see since the 119 update. Subaru. Group 4, you will always see the Alpha. I, for the most part...
Be specific, though. You mostly see the Subaru BRZ.
Being the little rebel I am, try to go through and use something that isn't all that common, which is why, well, earlier in this stream, I was running around with a Mustang. I put a GT40 on here. I put a Jaguar on here. Put multiple cars by multiple manufacturers. But on the flip side of that, on occasion, I want to go through and see what all the hubbub is about. It's taken me 5 laps, but I finally got a 133.9.
With what?
WRX.
You should be able to get a 128 with the WRX.
Right. But again, since this is my first time in a Subaru, all the car's dynamics vary depending upon the manufacturer. No two cars drive exactly the same. So it's just a matter of finding the car that fits your driving style. Obviously, if it's taking me 5 laps to get within 2 seconds of my best time, I am in the wrong car.
Oh, yeah. You should be driving the $11 million BMW McLaren.
So not.
So yes. That car is awesome. I can't drive it for shit, but I love it. What's the matter, you? I guess I'm gonna have to go kick Alex's ass. What do you mean, no? Because why? I just do that. Don't lie. I'm not lying. You are lying. Just by saying you're not lying, you're lying. No, I should take it and keep it. Oh, that's going on nicely. Now let's... Not that one. Let's throw that in garbage. Okay, then. Then you probably shouldn't be on that chair if you hurt yourself. Alex, go throw those in the green bin.
Outside?
Yes, outside. Oh, I gotta put this in this stubber. Hold on. A little bit of patience, baby girl. I understand that you're sick and cranky, but no reason not to have a little bit of patience.
Yeah, 7 laps in, the fastest I can get is 133.811. So, let's try another card. Now, the reason why I said car shopping and take all my best splits, my best time would have been on 133.1.
Dirty.
Okay.
No, Simon, right, you're not going up front. Alright, so we are not doing that one.
Well, I'm not giving you something that's going to make you sicker.
Alright, so let's come back in here. Room to be specific. See, as illogical as it sounds, part of my problem is the fact of I also, instead of functionality, it's kind of like, okay, I want to go for like cool factor. So let's see here. What have I got group three wise in my garage?
This is what don't you have group three in your garage?
Actually, I've got quite a few stuff I don't have. I'm not doing the Audi. I always come back to this thing. I don't know why. I just do. I love this car. Wish I could get it to do what I want it to do when I want it to do it.
No, it's not the Audi.
No, it is my Ford GT.
I don't know what you can't get that to do.
Not spin out on turns one or two.
Well, that's all in control.
All right, I'm working on it. It's a process.
It's all a process. I understand the process, or as you'd say, I understand your pain, but it is, as you said to me, something you just gotta knuckle down and get used to. I mean, hell. Look how far you come since I started playing.
Okay, this by default is going to be a slow lap because I did not hit full speed. Let's try that again. I was not at full speed coming around that corner.
Corner one.
Four. No, the lead-in corner.
Little teeny tiny one before you start. what do you classify as full speed coming off that corner?
Actually, I'll be able to answer that in just a second.
One. Would you like another?
That ain't it.
10,000 laps later.
I haven't even completed the lap yet in this car.
I know, that's because you keep resetting. Why don't you just do the lap, get the next the turn right on the next round, and ta-da.
Okay.
132 the only
miles
time
an
I reset on those first turns is if I end up getting a penalty. Okay, get. My chair is not a ramp.
Yep. that.
I want one of these.
Want one of what?
Okay.
We'll get. I mean, in real life.
Good one.
And they're kind of hard to come by around here now.
Just save your pennies. It'll be fine.
No, that's not why they're hard to come by. They're hard to come by because most of the ones that are here are destroyed.
What are we talking about?
We were talking about a car. The Honda 1997 Honda Civic CXR hatchback.
Oh.
SRX, one or the other.
What are you doing with that?
I am driving around Laguna Seca on it. In it. On it. I guess I'm probably on it because it's Honda Civic.
Alright. I'm going to hop off here, try and rest a little bit because I feel like my sinus is about to go back to fucking off.
Alright. Well, thanks for jumping in to the live stream. Thank you for following
the
live stream.
Get better soon.
No problem. Thanks, guys.
And I love you, and kiss my grandson for me.
Love you too, and I would if he was here.
I know. Okay, bye.
All right, bye.
And I'm going to end my live stream there. So that's actually a really good place to end it.